Good morning, my dear students. Welcome back in your English grammar class for standard 6. And today's topic is
objects of verb. Chapter number 10, objects of verb.
Before starting this chapter, have a look. Just open page number 57 and have a look here. A cartoon is given here. So just try to read it. A girl is saying that magician make me a cartoon. Magician, make me a cartoon.
So here, she said, make me a cartoon.
Fine. Now, magician, please make me a cartoon. So, by the given sentence, by the given command, magician understood that she is trying to say that she needs to transfer herself into cartoon. So he said, here you become a cartoon. So what happened? The girl wants a picture of cartoon for her. But what magician understood? That the girl is saying to become herself a cartoon. So this is the main, what is the main difference here? So the difference is, so the problem is due to the object. So
in this chapter,
we will talk about how we should use object and what is the exact location of object before verb or given or after the given verb. So in this chapter, we will learn about the location of object and what is the meaning of object and what do you and how many types of objects are given.
And you can see that
how many types of objects may be in a sentence. So let's start our topic. So my dear student, if we categorize it, then we will get two types of objects. First one is direct object. Second one is direct object, and second one is your indirect object. So my dear students, direct object. Take an example. First, this take a statement. Like, Danny, here, just erase it. Danny painted the wall. So here the subject Danny. What Danny did? Danny painted.
Painted to whom?
Painted the wall. Painted the wall. Here work done is, a verb is directly connected with object, that is wall. So here the wall is your direct object. Take some another example, like you can say that, just turn your page here. Sara picked strawberries. Picked strawberries. What she picked? She picked, Sara picked strawberries. So here strawberry is directly connected with verb. So a strawberry, strawberries, here the word strawberries is your direct object. Next one, they call him. They called him. What they did? They called. To whom? To him. So again, him is your direct object. So my dear students, keep a point in your mind that only action verbs can have direct object. So this is compulsion, or you can say that this is a compulsory, that a action verb, only action verb like doing, jumping, eating, crying, something like that. This is the action where you are doing some action. Action verbs, only action verbs have a, you can say that, direct object. So you can say that the object of the verb usually follows the verb. So we can say that in a given sentence, if you want to find out what is your direct object, then try this trick. Just try to ask a question. What question? Whom or what? After the verb, just ask whom or what. Like for example, Danny painted the wall. What he painted? What? Ask the question. What he painted? Then you get the answer, the wall. So the wall is your direct answer. Fine? So in this situation, we just get to know that if you want to find out the direct object from your given sentence, then just ask a question with the help of what and whom, then you will get the answer, and that particular answer is your direct object. So now my dear students, just move on to your another topic, that is your indirect object. Now, just my father wrote the principal. What a letter. Thank you.
trust.
Here, my dear students, great grandmother is a subject, is a verb. After the verb, what is the me? And then a dress. So there are two objects, me and a dress. So here, grandma sent me a dress. So according to the rule says that direct object. Rule says that the here me. So here me is your indirect object and address is your direct object. Why? Because grandma sent. What sent? Ask a question. What sent? Address. So I have told you whenever you you ask a question that what or whom, then the answer will be your direct object. So grandma sent. What sent? Address. Here address. So here address is your direct object, and then the second object will be your indirect object. So here me is your indirect object. So now my dear student, this chapter is completed. Yes. Now they are just turn page number 50. There are lots of exercises are given, A, B, C, D, E. So just try to do it yourself, and then when you will get your manual, then just do it in your notebook. So my dear student, just pay attention to the given table. So here, my dear students, this is very important that receives or direct object. The name suggests this is the direct object. So it directly affects to the verb. And what about indirect object? It affects to the direct object. And direct object affects to the verb. So this is very important thing. Just keep in your mind that in the given sentence, the object, if in the given sentence, if there are two objects, then the object which affects verb, that is your direct object, and some other way to find out the direct object is that just ask question what or whom to verb. So just add a question what or whom to verb, and your answer will be your direct object. And what about indirect object? Indirect object affects to direct object. So, and if you want to get the answer, and if you want to get to find out the indirect object in a given sentence, then just ask a question to verb. Then to whom? Pay attention. To whom? And your answer will be your indirect object. Or you can say that in some different situations you need to ask a question to the verb, that for whom, and then the answer will be your indirect object. So my dear students, now today we get to know that in a given sentence there may be one subject, one object, or maybe more than one object, that is two object. So if there are two objects, then the object directly connected with, directly dependent or directly affected with verb is your direct object, and the second will be your indirect object. So my dear students, that's all for the today's class. We will meet in